word searches, quiz games, interactive timelines, word scrambles, name randomizers, and much, much more. All these are options that you can create really easily using this particular website, flippity.net. In today's video, I'm gonna have a brief tutorial of how to use a site. There's no need to sign up for it. You can just immediately start using it as long as you have access to Google Spreadsheets. Hey there, it's Erica from Ever Educating, and this channel is all about teaching tips, tools, ideas, and resources for new college instructors. Go ahead and click the subscribe button if you want to make sure not to miss any new content. Before I actually share my screen with you and show you Flippity, I just want to tell you that it is a great website because you do not need to sign up for anything to use it. However, you do need to have access to Google Drive and Google Spreadsheets. So if you do not have a Gmail account, that is something that you will need in order to use this tool, because basically it's a website where you put in information into templates that are already created for you that are Google Spreadsheets, and what they curate are various types of games that you can use with your students. And so it automates it for you once you put in the information in the Google Spreadsheet and hit publish. Okay, so now let's go ahead and see my screen. Here's what the website looks like once you go to it. And you'll notice that it has a range of different games that you can create yourself. So like I mentioned before, you're basically going to go to the instructions tab or the template, and you just fill out the template that it creates for you. And once you do that and you publish it to the web, it automates the link that has the, whatever game you created. So to make that easier to understand, you go to instructions here, for example, you have a template that you click on and you make a copy of it for your Google Drive. It will already be filled out as an example. So all you would do is you would obviously edit this to change it for the information that you want. You can change the name of the game show in this case, and here are the categories. Okay, so you might have terminology, history, you know, whatever categories you want for your exam review. And then you have the questions and the answers, and obviously how many points they're worth are down here. So once you create the whole thing, you change it with whatever material you want to put, you would do file and publish to the web and click publish. Once you do that, you'll exit out of this, and when you have this sheet, get the link here, you'll click this link and it will lead you to the game show that you created for your students. Now what I do is after I create the game, however it is I'd like it, I go ahead and unpublish it from the web. So you just put file, publish to the web, and you'll see here that it's published. You click to unpublish it. Now I'm not sure, potentially for this game, you might actually have to keep it published until you play it, until you have the review happen with your students, and then unpublish it. But for example, if we go back to the list, I've already created a crossword puzzle and a word search. And so all I did was I filled out the template, I published it, and then once I got the link that took me to the game, I saved it as a PDF. And once that was done on my computer, I unpublished it from the web because I knew that I had my own copy and I can make as many copies of it as I wanted. So I do think the crossword puzzle is a good idea, for example, as a small quiz for terminology. So, you know, I teach literature courses, right? So I go over a lot of terminology with my students. So I can create a crossword puzzle where the clues are the definitions of the terms that we're learning. And then obviously the words that you put in the crossword are the terms. And so in that way, it's a bit more fun. And also students get clues of what letters are in some of these words, which could help spark their memory of what certain terms are if they're not sure when just looking at the definition. What's great too is, let's say you create that crossword puzzle, you'll see in the page next to the printer icon will be a refresh icon. And when you do that, it refreshes the page and the design of the crossword puzzle changes. So it's the same clues, but a different design. And so you can do that a few times and save those PDFs. And so now, you know, you'll decrease the level of cheating, if there is any, because they look different. So it's not exactly easy to see, you know, what your next door neighbor is writing on their sheet of paper compared to the person who has their particular design. Okay, so you can do that with a few of these, just something to keep in mind as well. And so what I'm going to do here is I'm going to show you, what's great is you can see demos of what's already existing.
So for example, I do like Jeopardy games when I'm reviewing for exams with my students. And so if you click demo here, you'll see this quiz game. And so you have obviously the categories and then the board. And so when you click on it, let's say, you know, you have the four teams and, you know, team one says, I want world capitals for 100. So you click it, you get the question. Once they answer the question, you can click it and see the answer. But then you can also say, okay, they got it right or they got it wrong. Then you click again, and now it's already done. So you know which ones have already been used, and the team has 100 points. Okay, so now let's say you have, I'll take an Espanol for 200. Okay, click that one, the answer, and let's say, okay, well, team two got that one wrong. And now they have negative 100, right? Because in Real Jeopardy, you actually get negative points if you get the question wrong. Okay, and so it keeps track of the points for you, and it keeps track of which ones have been used for you as well. So definitely a game that I use when I have reviews for my students. Now, if we head on back, there's obviously, again, a lot here. I think for timelines, if you teach literature or if you teach history, this can be very interesting. Or if you have students researching a certain person or a certain, you know, theory, whatever the case may be, here's an example here, right? So Mr. Rogers' timeline, and you create an interactive timeline. And so there's all these little links here attached to the timeline. So you can kind of see what's going on at different points of his life. You can embed videos, embed images, etc., etc. So this is one, again, that I think could be actually a very complex assignment that you give your students to complete. Scavenger hunts have been a bit more trendy recently. So digital scavenger hunts, right? So you can see a demo of that too. So let's click a lock here. What has keys but no locks, space but no room. You can enter, but you can't exit, okay? And you can have here, do you want to show a hint, right? Here it is. Right? And you fill it out and go forward and unlock it, and you keep going through the rest of the hunt. So you can see which ones might appeal to you. Obviously, not all of them are going to be helpful, but I do think, like I said, crosswords are great for, you know, quizzes. You can also have the quiz show for the review. You can do the random name picker with all your students' names so that, you know, you prove that I'm not trying to put you on the spot. It's really just this name picker that is picking the names randomly, and that's how you kind of get people who are a bit more quiet to talk if it's something that you're interested in doing. I do have a video that's about how to help shy students speak up or at least communicate more with you in class, and so I'll make sure I link that below in the description box. Other than that, a lot of these I wouldn't actually use, right? So typing test, obviously not. But I do think there's a few here that you might find of interest. And you can also tell your students, you know, how they can use it for other classes as well. So for example, the flashcards, right, can be very helpful as far as it goes, right? So you can have them use it for their own learning, okay? And then you could also randomize the order of the cards and so on and so forth. So I do think it's a site that you can actually tell students about so they can create their own tools for their learning experience. And then potentially if you want to gamify your classroom, one that you might consider using is a progress indicator. I'll show you the demo here. Because here you can kind of have like, well, how many, you know, assignments have you completed? If you need to do 5 out of 8 options, then you can kind of keep track. You know, here's where you are on the scoreboard, right? And so obviously some stuff you don't want to share with your fellow students in the way that this is here. But if you do have some kind of gamification going in your classroom where you have a scoreboard of high scores for doing a certain element of the class, then you might have this, you know, very easy to create, but, you know, nicer to look at than just like a regular Google spreadsheet. Okay. So that's just one other option as well that I wanted to point out in case you're interested in a more gamified classroom. You could also do this with the tournament brackets if you have some kind of competition or debate going on with your students as well.
If you have any questions or specific ideas of how to use this website, please let me know in the comments below and click the like button if you're going to be using this tool in the future. If you have any suggestions for EdTech tools you want me to go over or use or create tutorials for, you can also let me know that in the comments, or you can fill out the survey that I have linked in the description. I'll be doing, again, a lot more videos about these kind of online tools. So, you know, I want to make sure I hit the ones that you're interested in the most.